Hi, Linda Roberts here. So I just wanted to hop on real quick and ask you a question. How are your boundaries? Not just your physical boundaries, but your emotional boundaries and your energetic boundaries. So I want to share a scenario with you of a client that I had. It was a week ago, and the dog I was speaking with in the animal communication session had no idea that she was misbehaving. So I was hired by the human because the human said, "Oh my gosh, my dog is pulling me on the leash. I'm getting older in my years and it's dangerous and the dog is jumping up on people and just not behaving and I don't know what to do. You know, I've tried things, but I'm just not getting through to her." So I talked with the dog, and the dog says, "Oh my gosh, I love my human. She is so great. I love her, I love her, I love her. I can do anything I want. I love her." I go, "Wait, you can what? Say that again." And she's like, "I can do anything I want." And I said, "What do you mean?" And she said, "She doesn't care. She doesn't get mad at me. She doesn't tell me I need to do this or that or anything. I can do whatever I want." And I said, "Oh, okay, this makes some sense." So I uncovered the scenario. The human got this dog because her other dog passed away. So she was grieving this other dog when she acquired this new younger puppy. So during the grieving process, if you have unfortunately experienced it, sometimes our emotions get the best of us, and we aren't fully present, and we're not as dedicated or diligent with things as we possibly could be. So, what I said to the human was, "Well, you got to teach this dog some boundaries for your safety and for hers and for other people." She was jumping up on people who would come to visit. She was pulling the human on the dog walks and just very unruly and difficult to manage. So what we did was we did a couple of sessions where we talked with the dog and I asked the dog, "Well, how do you want to be trained? How do you want to be guided?" And she's, you know, very food motivated. Not all dogs are food motivated, but this one is. And so I said, "Okay, well, let's use some treats to help you to learn some of this behavior that your human is needing from you right now because you love her, right? So you want to stay in this home and you want to be a part of her life." And the dog was so excited and, "Oh yes, absolutely." So what we did over a few sessions was we worked on getting the dog to understand boundaries. I had to talk with the human a little bit about how she defined boundaries to find out what she was looking for, and then I communicated that to the dog and said, "Okay, when you're on the leash, here's the plan. Don't pull, but walk closely to your human because if you pull too hard, you could knock her down. And you could possibly scare other animals." And the dog was like, "Oh, I don't want to scare any other animals. I'm just excited. I'm just so excited to see them and to be around them." So I let her know, "Okay, you've got to be a little more calm in the walk." And so over a couple of sessions, she was able to come to terms with some of the healthy boundaries. And I got a good report back from her. So I'm really happy that the communication was able to help her. But I thought we all could learn from this situation as well in how are we holding our boundaries up. So maybe you can, in a loving and gentle way, ask yourself, where am I softening up my boundaries? Where do I need to firm them up? How can I say no in a loving and compassionate way? So think about that, and if you have any questions about that, feel free to check out my website about my services in animal communication or shamanic healings. My website is www.thewhispersoflove.com. Thanks. Bye for now.